What's up, YouTube? It's Dewan, and I'm back with another Packet Trace tutorial. Today, we're going to configure a router on a stick network. We're going to do some DHCP, get that configured, and then we're going to test everything out. All right, I got a layer two access layer switch here. What's going on? I named it switch SW1. First thing we want to do is see if there's some VLANs already configured. I believe I did. We have VLAN 10, VLAN 20, VLAN 30, VLAN 40, and VLAN 50. VLAN 50 is not on this switch, but I still created it anyway, even though it's not needed. So here, all the ports with the corresponding PC number are configured for that particular VLAN, and I have the VLAN listings here. And since there's no VLAN 50, I don't know if you know how to remove VLANs. So let's go ahead and remove VLAN just in case you don't know how to do that. So we'll do a no VLAN 50. It's as simple as that. And do a show VLAN brief. VLAN 50's gone. No need for VLAN 50. And then we can even remove it from here. All right. The next thing we need to do is see if the trunk is configured. So let's do a show run. And we'll do gigabit 01. It is configured for switch port mode trunk. Now everything else is configured on this switch, and we can check all the ports just to verify. But if you do a show VLAN brief, that shows you what ports are assigned to that VLAN anyway. So as far as this building one is concerned, the access layer is good to go. The PCs should be set up for DHCP. We can go in here and check. Yep. And right now they have a 169.254. That's an APIPA IP address. That means that the NIC is not talking to anything outside of itself. So, and that IP address is actually good if you're connecting two PCs together. You could actually take a crossover cable and assign a APIPA address on both sides within the same range or whatever, and you can actually make two PCs talk to each other that way. But let's go ahead and pull up HQ, show IP interface brief. Nothing's configured. Let's do a show IP DHCP binding, see if nothing's there. And let's also do a show IP route to see what's in the routing table. Nothing's in the routing table. Now, here are the VLANs that we need to configure for this device. HQ is actually doing the routing for building one. So we're going to go ahead and go config T interface gigabit 01. And we'll just do the description here. Connection to building one. And we'll do a no shut to bring up this interface. Now we are configuring this interface with sub interfaces. And to do that, this is what you do. You can either exit out of here or you can do it from here. So you would do gigabit 01.10. That's what I name it. You can name it actually whatever, because what's important is this part right here, encapsulation.1q10. That's what tags that VLAN to say, hey, you're the default gateway for VLAN 10. And then you add an IP address. Say 10.1/24. As simple as that. And then so we're going to do this all the way up to VLAN 40. That's working, and what we can do now is set up this DHCP. So we'll go IP DHCP excluded address. Now I'm going to exclude the default gateway because this will hand that out if you do not do this and you configure the network ID, the network portion first. It will hand out that. It'll handle it out anyway. It does what it wants to do. So I would recommend excluding everything that you do not want your router to hand out. And now we'll do the DHCP pools. And we'll just name it 10 through 40. and network ID will be 192.168.10.0 because that's the actual network ID for this /24 subnet. All right. Going here. Oh, we actually need to configure the default router too. Otherwise, they will not know how to get outside of the network. So, and that's all you have to do for that. All that's configured. Now, if we do a show IP, let's do a show IP route. We now have routes in the routing table. But what you'll notice is you have this L, which is locally, and then the C, which is connected. So they're locally connected, which means that they're connected to the router. They're inside the router. There's an actual interface in the router. The routing table is, it knows where everything is. There's no need to do no EIGRP rip or anything like that. You can just basically start pinging. And what we can do to find some IP addresses, we can do a couple of things. But what I like to do is show IP DHCP bindings. And what this does, it shows you everything that has an IP address. And as you, and what you can see is VLAN 10, VLAN 20, VLAN 30. And VLAN 40, but VLAN 30 only has one IP address assigned. Want to guess why? Two of these PCs are not configured for DHCP. That's configured. Sorry, clicked the wrong thing. All right, see, it's configured for static. Otherwise, it would have showed up in the bindings. So you know you have a problem if you don't see a MAC address or a device in the bindings. So we'll go in here and it sends that request. There's a reply and there's, it's fulfilled. All right. Now if we go back up here to HQ and run bindings again, we have all the IP addresses and we can start pinging 192.168.10.2. And we wait. Yep. Let's do the same for 40. And we'll just randomly ping stuff. All right. Now, if we come over here to command prompt and do an IP config, no default gateway. Now here we know we have a problem. What might that problem be? Let's go ahead and show run pipe section and let's do DHCP. Can you do section? Let's see. Is that an option? No, you can't even do section. So let's do begin DHCP. And we have, for VLAN 10, it does have the default router. So why? Why do you think that has no default gateway? Let's do an IP config slash release. It probably received this IP address before it actually, I actually typed it in. So I'm betting that's the problem. Yep. As you can see, it's back. So if it sends the request before you actually get everything configured, it will send a reply of what you have configured. So that's why the default gateway was not in there. All right. So let's take something from here. IP config. And what we'll do is we'll just verify with this PC1. We'll have these two ping each other. Ping 192.168.30.3. It'll take a moment. And timeout successful. See, the reply came back. Everything's good to go. And that's Inter-VLAN routing with DHCP configured. I hope this tutorial was informative for you. If you have any questions or comments, please feel free to leave them in the section below. like this video, subscribe this video, and please share it with your friends. I appreciate everyone's encouragement. I appreciate all my subscribers. This has been an amazing opportunity, you know, to put out this information that I've been lucky to obtain throughout my career. So hopefully I'm helping some people learn a little bit that they may not know, and just, you know, I'm doing the best that I can to help as many people as I can. And again, I thank you for viewing. Peace.